Yeah. When did the, because I know a big part of your work now is about animals.
Yeah.
And when did that piece become important in your life?
That piece became important in my life when I had my dog Rosie. And I just, I hadn't had a dog since my
So
mom.
just so growing up, you weren't really an animal person?
I didn't have a lot of animals, being raised in Brooklyn. We always had dogs. We always had two dogs and or one dog. We ended up with one dog. And when she passed away a year after my mom, I said, I can't do this. I can't do the dogs. But before I left that apartment in Brooklyn, I had 17 feral cats in the backyard. And I never saw myself as a cat lady, but my dad built a house to keep them warm. I asked him, can you make me a house? We put a drop light in it with insulation. And during the winter, cats that would ordinarily fight, they were all piled in this box, under this heat lamp. It was really adorable. And I thought, I need to get these cats neutered, fixed, and get a home because I'm moving to California. So I felt like that was my good karma, like my good animal karma. And then years later, I had a bone surgery. I had started with bone surgeries when I was 10, believe it or not, like what 10-year-old has to go through bone surgeries, but it led up to the person that I am. And I had this major bone surgery, and I thought, oh my God, I'm so stressed out. I was selling real estate and I couldn't heal because I was so stressed out. And my brother, in his infinite wisdom, said to me, Susie, take a silly class online. But I had already been like this huge animal girl and lover of animals and pets. I didn't have a farm because I lived in Brooklyn. And I took an animal intuition class, and it was like a teleclass, and the teacher would put up, and I kind of teach like this too when I do an animal intuition class. The teacher would put up a picture of a pet, and I should say, meditate, let your weirdo go, relax, and just write what you get. And I was like writing volumes, and that's how my business really started. I would do it for friends and family, and then people were inundating me, and I knew so much like details about this woman's pet. It sounded like a Disney movie. Like, I never thought myself a writer. I am now, but people were calling me from the class for readings. A veterinarian called me. She was in the class, and I gave her readings. And I would literally, Thomas, I was so into making sure that I was specific and good and accurate. I would meditate for half an hour. I would journal on a pet photo for another half hour. And then I'd be on the phone with somebody for an hour. And I did this for 6 years. And then I said to Spirit, I can't keep writing down. Like, my hand is hurting. Like, I would be, I have books and books and books filled with animal readings.
Wow.
And I said to Spirit, I can't, like, you have to figure out a better way to get this information to me. Cause this is like, I'm getting busier and I can't spend 3 hours with one client. Otherwise, forget this,
Right.
And but I loved it. And I remember my husband going, don't quit real estate. I mean, this is a little crazy. And I said, yeah, I agree with you. It is kind of crazy, but I love it. And I did it. And all of a sudden, I didn't need the pen and paper anymore. It would
Right.
just be thoughts. And then and then I kind of started to, I was on the phone with the this celebrity's girlfriend, and all of a sudden her father started to appear in the photo across the room from me. Like, I didn't know it was her father, and I started to say, there's a man. And I didn't say he was in my photo with my dad, but I knew it was her dad because he was in the photo of me and my dad. And I said, this is what this man looks like. And he said he didn't get to say goodbye. And I said, he's very thin. And I said, and he has black glasses. And I said, I think it's your father. And she said, it's my father. And her father passed away at 6 a.m. in Manhattan during spin class. And he was ultra fit and he had a heart attack and he didn't get to say goodbye. And he was a big fashion designer. And so that's kind of how it really started. I was in animal mediumship. And then when I realized I'm getting dead people, I said to them, don't scare me. I have anxiety. Don't be walking through my house dead. If you want me to do this work, like I would have a conversation in my head to spirit. If you want me to do this work, you know, give me the messages so you don't scare me and I could get the messages to them. And actually what's really weird is I'm a girl that always had major anxiety, panic attacks. I would get on a subway and I would just be completely drenched by the time I would get to New York. From Brooklyn to New York or Staten Island, I would be like just saturated in so much sweat from so much anxiety because I was obviously doing things I wasn't supposed to do, like working in an office, you know?
Right.
And spirit is so good. It's so good because when I started doing spirit work, my anxiety, if I start to feel anxious, at all, I just go into meditation now, mm-hmm. or I start talking to my spirit guides or my people, and I'm telling you, it's like it has healed me on so many levels doing this work, and I think like if anybody has the ability to do this work, and they think they love it, they should nurture it because it's been amazing. It's better than anything I've ever done.